What is going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty. We are here in week 5 as the Wolfpack. We're on the road for the second time this season, and they're looking for another big win as they'll be taking on the Navy Midshipmen. Illinois Tech has started the year pretty okay, 2-1 to start the year, 2 straight wins, but going up against the number 4 rush offense of Navy, it'll be a tough matchup for the defense, but the offense on the field first, Sean Kelly from under center starting from the 23, and the Illinois Tech Wolfpack will start through the air this ball game, finding McKnight for a 12-yard gain. That's a nice way to get the game started. Ball at the 35-yard line, going left side, and Brandon Archer gets run over, and that's going to be a 3-yard loss for Caden Garrick out the gate. DJ Palmore off the snap puts Brandon Archer on his tush, second down for Illinois Tech. Kelly from the pistol will look to throw right side. He's got Howard with the catch, and Howard picks up 8 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 5 from the 40-yard line. Wolfpack go to the screen, but Kelly can't get it off in time. As that brings up 4th down, Wolfpack will be forced to punt. Out comes the Wolfpack defense. Here goes Navy's run offense, and there goes a great play in the backfield to get things going by Alan Kidd. Just need to see this more consistently throughout the season, but especially in this game, containing runners. Do not let them get outside and get to the edge. 2nd and 12, Calvin Cass Jr. motions right once again. Toggle Smith pitches it to him, and he's brought down near the 35. Really good tackle there by Reed, who's been kind of a liability in the open field. But 3rd and 4, Smith looks to throw, tries to run. Corbin there to contain and brings him down, but Isaiah Taylor will get credit for the tackle, but a 3 and out for Navy. And here comes the Illinois Tech offense back on the field. They get started from the 26-yard line. This time running away from Palmore, Caden Garrick crossing the 30, falls forward, 6-yard gain, but Garrick is down. Only 2 carries into the game, but holding his head, probably a concussion, so he most likely won't be returning. 1st and 10, Kelly to the air, looks for McKnight, finds him on the screen underneath, and McKnight picks up 9 yards, 2 for 2 so far today on receptions. Now with 2nd and short, Bennett Hayden, the fullback, in motion to give to Anthony Bishop up the middle. 1st down, Bishop, 4-yard gain, and to move the chains for the Wolfpack. Kelly looks to throw pressure, but gets it off underneath to Howard. Solid catch there for a 10-yard gain. Illinois Tech comes out 5 wide, 1st and 10. Another screen. That is Jason Howard working upfield. 1st down, big hit, 12-yard gain. Pretty good start for Howard, 30 yards on 3 receptions. And so far, just really the game plan has been working underneath this zone coverage from Navy. But now Howard's down. Took a pretty big shot at the end of that play. That's 2 injuries for Illinois Tech to their starters in the first quarter alone. 1st and 10, Bishop running left side, tripped up and falls forward near the 1st down marker, 10-yard gain. That'll make it 2nd and inches, now 3rd and inches, as they'll go back to the ground game. That is Anthony Bishop, 2-yard gain, 1st down, Illinois Tech. Inside the 15-yard line, Kelly from the pistol looks end zone for McKnight, and he dropped it. It had to happen eventually, but why in the end zone? A perfect play call. They went cover 3. Great route by McKnight, but you have to catch the ball there. Now it's 3rd and 10, still at the 12-yard line. Kelly from the pistol, who looked to throw 4 receivers on the field. This time is T.C. Shelton in the end zone. He's got hands like glue. Touchdown, Illinois Tech. And the Wolfpack will strike first. Really working those post routes against zone coverage. Nice play call there by the offense. Navy from the 30, they'll start option left this time, and it's Cass Jr. Quick pitch to him, and Reed can't get off his block. Cass Jr. around the edge, past midfield, and finally tracked down by Thomas Corbin. 32-yard gain. 1st and 10, Smith keeps it running option left, and is tracked down by Simmons before he can get too far. Solid gain, though. Now it's 2nd down and 2. They go option right, and a wonderful play there by Alan Kidd again. 3-yard loss for Navy makes it 3rd and 4. Can the defense get them off the field? Smith looks to throw, dancing around in the pocket, finally steps up and looks to run. He's going to lower his shoulder and picks up a 1st down as Navy inside the red zone, 1st and 10. Smith working right side, pitches to Romine, reads on his butt, get up and try to make the tackle, but he can't do it. Touchdown, Navy. They will tie the ball game up. Just everyone getting just destroyed by this Navy run game, and we have a tie ball game. Lucas Baker deep for Illinois Tech on the return. He was huge last week against Western Michigan. Can he keep that up this week against the Navy Midshipmen, working outside left sideline again? He was big this area last week, past the 45, then shoved out just shy of midfield. 44-yard return, and out comes Kelly in the offense. They're going to try to work their option game a little bit. Here is Kelly carries upfield and picks up 7 yards. 2nd down and 3, no sign of Caden Garrick, so Anthony Bishop still in the ball game. He gets the football here up the middle, and Anthony Bishop shedding a tackle, 8-yard gain for him. Kelly to the air, first down, has all day again, runs out to his right as no one gets open, finds McKnight with a solid catch that time, but for some reason can't catch a wide open pass in the end zone. But his first and 10 Wolfpack from the 25-yard line, Kelly throws, he's got Vandenberg near the marker, and they will give it to the Wolfpack, 10-yard gain, ball to 15. Now it's third and six, Kelly to the air, trying to find someone open, rolls out to his left, his strong side throws for T.C. Shelton, he's in again, touchdown Illinois Tech. T.C. Shelton, two touchdown receptions in the first half on two receptions. That's not a bad start. And it's time for our first studio update of the game, 3-0 Boston College, 3-0 Florida State, and that game is headed to overtime. Boston College leads by a touchdown after the first possession. Out comes the Navy offense again. Pitch left side for Cass Jr. He's going to get brought down by Kidd and Simmons. That's a 15-yard run for Navy, and their offense just moving the ball at will on the ground. First and 10. This time the pitch man is covered, so in goes Smith, and he's brought down after a 3-yard gain. Better job that time. Second down, Smith comes to the line. They go option right this time. Smith on the keeper will be brought down by Deion Reeves after an 11-yard run. First down, Tago Smith. Cass Jr. moving left this time. They're going to go option. This is Smith working up the middle. He breaks a tackle. He could go all the way. Convoy in front, but they don't block for him. Alan Kidd just barely finding a way to track down Smith from behind. First and goal, Navy. They go option right again. Smith will shove Simmons away and is brought down by Hunter. That's another 3-yard gain for Smith, and they're inside the 5-yard line. Cass Jr. motioning left. This is going to be a keeper for Smith. He just faked out the entire defense. Touchdown, Tago Smith. And we are tied again. There were two guys on defense there to make a play, and both of them went after Cass Jr. instead of going after Smith. Illinois Tech trying to get back down the field, and that's some more points before halftime. A little under 3 minutes left, and there goes Sean Kelly working past midfield, 26-yard gain. So the defense is having a hard time stopping a run on both sides. Kelly to the air finds McKnight. Nice catch and a first down. That's good for 12 yards to move the chains. Howard out officially for the rest of the game, so McKnight should be seeing a lot more passes thrown his way. Screen set up on first and 10, but they covered it and didn't really get any pressure on Kelly. He just stayed in the pocket and found Nick Grayson for a 10-yard gain. Inside the 25-yard line, second down and six. There it goes. Bishop trying to get to the outside, but no one blocked the linebacker. He's brought down. He could have still been running towards the end zone. Now it's third down and seven. Kelly to the air, and that pass is knocked away. Fourth down. Illinois Tech will send on Jesus Gonzalez for a field goal. This one is up. Good hold by McCullough. And this field goal just barely sneaks through. And it's studio update time once again. And down goes number three, Florida State. Boston College wins 46-38. They move on to 4-0 on the season. Not a lot of time left in the first half for Navy to get down the field, but let's see what they can do. Smith looking to throw for the first time this afternoon. Lobs it downfield. It is nearly picked off by Isaiah Taylor. You got to make the play there. 0-for-1 goes Tago Smith through the air. Second and 10. They fake the option, go to Cologne, and he's got a first down. That's good enough for 10 yards to move the chains for Navy. They're going to hurry back to the line. Second down and inches now. Smith throws as Tillman with the catch pass midfield up to the 45. That's good for 11. They'll hurry back to the line again. Smith looks to throw. Will take off the run up the middle. Is going to get near the first down, but brought down shy by Hunter. That's a 9-yard gain to bring up second and one. And here they go back to the line again. Smith looking to throw. Flips it out to Carmona. And Carmona inside the 30 down to the 26-yard line. 8-yard gain. And Navy just having no issues throwing the ball so far. Smith to the air is going to try to run here and is going to get the first down, brought down by Cam Wolf. They're inside the 15-yard line with 9 seconds left, and they're still hurrying back to the line. 5 seconds on the clock. They still have a timeout to use. And Smith's going to try to run, and he will be brought down. They can't get the timeout called, and it will stay a 3-point game at halftime. This is maybe the second or third time this has happened this season. Teams not using timeouts to kick field goals, but a 3-point lead for the Wolfpack. Can they hold on to it in the second half? Navy on offense to begin quarter number three, and this Wolfpack defense needs to be a little more aggressive here with their coverage of the run, and there goes a good start for them. 4-yard loss. Good play in the backfield by Reed, as Smith was kind of boggling around there in the backfield. Second and 14. Simmons can't bring him down. Hunter can't bring him down. And it's Tago Smith down the sideline, shedding a tackle from Taylor and brought down after another 32-yard gain. Third down, this time Smith going to the air. He's got Carmona wide open inside the 25-yard line near the 20, 23-yard gain for the Navy Midshipmen. Trying to get in the end zone again. Smith keeps it, pitches it left to Cass Jr., but is taken away by Huggins, who's tripped up, and that's the first turnover of the afternoon. And for some reason, Navy is celebrating. I don't know why. Great play there by Kent Huggins. Read the play really well, got in the way of the pitch, and got the ball back to Illinois Tech, who's going to try to take a two-score lead here. Illinois Tech going to a screen, and Navy literally only rushing two people against a five-man line. That's a nice catch for Lucas Baker on the screen. That's good for six. Third and inches in comes the backup running back, Abraham Barrow. That's the first carry of the season for him. That's a five-yard gain to move the chains. Everyone in close on second and 10. Pitch right for Bishop. He gets Molly Watt behind the line. Five-yard loss. Third and 15. And the Wolfpack trying to move the chains here. Kelly to the air. Time to throw again. Finds T.C. Shelton, who is near the marker. He's got enough for a first down. It's pretty early in the year, but this connection between T.C. Shelton and Sean Kelly is pretty impressive. There goes Bishop working his way upfield, showing off the speed. 13-yard gain. First down, Illinois Tech. They have a chance here to get some points. Trying to go screen right side again is covered, but look at Grayson over the middle of the field. Nice catch, 9-yard gain. Navy is getting pretty much zero pressure right now on Sean Kelly in the backfield. Archer in motion on first and 10. Give right side to Bishop. He gets around the edge, shows off the speed. He's inside the 20, inside the 15, and finally wrestled down at the 7-yard line. 22-yard gain. Back to Bishop. He's inside the 5-yard line. Touchdown, Wolfpack. That's a 2-score lead. And Anthony Bishop, look at the lane they got open up on that play. That was pretty impressive. They lead by 10. A little bit of time left in the third quarter. Can Navy get down the field and score? That's going to be a keeper for Tago Smith. He fakes out the edge again and picks up a solid gain. Good for a first down. This just isn't a good look for this defense right now. Can't stop the run. Can't stop them through the air. But there goes a nice play on first and 10 by Spencer Simmons. As Tago Smith loses three. But every time they get a stop in the backfield, they give up a bigger play on the next play. Here goes Smith to the outside. Gabe Hunter can't make the tackle. Simmons trying to get there. He can't bring him down. And there goes Tago Smith again. This time good for 25 yards. That's been the issue for this defense today, not staying consistent. Smith steps up, throws towards the sideline for Carmona. That catch is indeed caught in bounds. First and 10, option right. Smith trying to get around the edge. They can't bring him down for some reason. He's inside the 5-yard line, down to the 3, and 178 yards for Tago Smith on 23 carries. Unbelievable performance from him. But there goes Alan Kidd making a big play in the backfield, third down and 3. Do they try to pick this up on the ground or through the air? Tago Smith options right, fakes out the defense again. He's in for another touchdown, 5-yard run. That'll take this down to a one-score game, a three-point game. And Illinois Tech on offense needs to try to get as much time off this clock on this possession as they can. Bishop on first and 10, can't get too far. That's a one-yard gain. Nowhere to go on second down. Now it's third down and 8. Illinois Tech goes 5-wide. Kelly throws, and this one is picked off by Battle. Navy gets the football back at the 40. Kelly just throwing that one a little too quickly. It looked like Battle was going to blitz off the left side of the line, and he ended up dropping back into coverage, and Navy gets the ball back, and they have a chance to take the lead. And obviously, coach has got to talk to Kelly about making better decisions, but here goes Navy on second down, and Smith is spun down after a 3-yard gain, third down and inches. Can the defense get them off the field? Smith options right, pitches to Romine. That is perfect defense right there. Romine brought down the backfield. That is exactly what Illinois Tech needs to do more often. Force the quick pitch, have someone on the edge to bring down the running back and get these guys off the field. Pretty long field goal here from Navy, but their kicker's got the ability to put this one through. We are tied at 24 with 5:22 left in the fourth quarter. Still anyone's game at this point, but the Wolfpack need to know that their run game really hasn't been stopped this far. And they got to depend on that run game here. Sean Kelly on the option, cuts up field and is just barely tripped down. After a 13-yard gain, he could still be running. Second down and 4, back to the option. That is Bishop up the middle, able to fall forward and pick up a 7-yard gain. First down, Wolfpack inside of 4:30. They keep this clock running. 4:16, Kelly going to the air. They go screen again. That's Baker underneath. Baker with the catch and upfield after a 6-yard gain. Nice way to keep this defense off guard. Second down and 4. Back to Bishop to the outside. Good blocking on the edge by the receivers. And Anthony Bishop tripped down inside the 30. Solid gain for him. He's got 100 on the game so far. Third down and 3. Big third down for the Wolfpack. This is Bishop to the outside. Good blocking in front. Bishop inside the 10-yard line. 2 minutes left. This has pretty much been a perfect drive. 1:43 on the clock. First and goal. Navy stacking the line. They go to the air on first and goal and find McKnight in the end zone. Touchdown, Illinois Tech. But did they score too quickly? Had a chance to burn Navy's timeouts, but that's going to give them the ball back with 1:33 left on the clock. And what a game this has been so far. Illinois Tech and Navy just trading punches all game long. Navy going to the air on first and 10. Check down to White in the backfield. The fullback able to cut up field, break a tackle, and pick up a first down. They're down to midfield. Already 17-yard gain. Second and 9. Smith going to the air. He's got a man open underneath. That is Scott working left, trying to get up field, breaking another tackle. This defense needs to bring these guys down on first contact. 20-yard gain for Scott. Ball at the 30-yard line, 48 seconds left, and Navy still needs a touchdown here. Smith all day to throw, trying to keep him contained as Cologne gets the catch. He breaks the tackle. He's inside the 20-yard line. All these yards after catching contact need to stop. Third down and 4. Smith trying to run. They thought they had the contain set up, but he's going to find a first down. Hit hard by Hunter, but it's first and goal, 17 seconds left. Illinois Tech needs a stop here. Smith to the air, takes off the run. Horn trying to track him down, but that's a touchdown for Tago Smith. And this ball game is an extra point away from being tied. 11 seconds left on the clock. What a drive from Navy. I mean, they spent a little over a minute moving the ball downfield with just no mistakes at all. Extra point attempt is going to go up. It is nearly blocked, but it is good. And we will head to the final seconds of the fourth quarter. Wolfpack trying to avoid overtime here as Sean Kelly looks to the air, has time to throw, fires for Archer downfield, and that ball will fall very short, and that will send this game to overtime. Navy won the toss and wants to play defense first. So here comes Illinois Tech on offense. It's Bishop to the outside. Blockers in front. Bishop inside the 10-yard line, inside the 5, down to about the 4. And that's a great start to the overtime period for the Wolfpack offense. First and goal. Bishop up the middle on the option. Near the goal line, he will power his way in for a touchdown. It only took 2 plays. And what a game for Bishop. After Caden Garrick went down, he has been the man for this offense so far. But here comes Navy on offense. They'll start through the air. Smith, time to throw, looks to check down to White, and White is brought down after a 7-yard gain. Navy looking to probably run the ball on 2nd and 3. That is a pitch right side to Romine. He is tripped up by Spencer Simmons just barely, but they pick up a first down. They are inside the 10-yard line. This time going option left. Smith pitches outside once again. Deion Reeves can't make the tackle, but Horn is there as that keeps him just shy of the goal line. 2nd and goal. And this defense needs to make a play here. 2nd down and goal. Option right side. That is Kidd getting shoved away. He could have made the stop, but that's a touchdown for Calvin Cass Jr. This is starting to get really embarrassing for this Wolfpack defense. They just cannot bring these guys down on first contact. Navy back on the field. We are in overtime period number 2. They'll go to the air again on first down, and Carmona's got a catch in the end zone. 1-play touchdown. What is Reed doing? All you got to do is turn around, pick the ball off. It was thrown right at you, and that's the ball game right there. But I don't know what this was. He wasn't looking for the ball. He didn't turn around. I probably should have clicked on right there because I figured that was going to happen. But here goes Illinois Tech back on offense, 2nd and 2, trying to go to the outside with Bishop, and the blocking is not there. 3rd down and 5. These guys got to do a better job of securing their blocks. 3rd and 5, going back to the ground game outside with Bishop. They're just keeping the ball on the ground. They can stop it. There goes a nice carry for Bishop. Good for a first down. In comes Abraham Barrow up the middle following a block. He is near the first down marker. They will give it to him. 1st and goal at the 3. Wolfpack go option. Kelly on the keeper. He's brought down behind the line. Should have gave it to Barrow there. 2nd down and goal. Bishop checks back in after getting a rest. Good blocking on the edge. That is Bishop to the goal line. He dives in. Touchdown, Illinois Tech. This game is going to be tied again. 3 overtime periods. Here goes Illinois Tech on offense. That is Bishop spinning ahead up the middle. That's a 6-yard gain for him. I haven't seen Kelly throw the ball yet. No T, but why risk it when the ground game's working this well? Kelly down to the 10-yard line will slide. 1st and 10 again for the Wolfpack. 2nd down and 10, that is Barrow to the outside. Good blocking on the edge again, and Abraham Barrow's in for a touchdown, his first of the afternoon. And that makes it another 1-touchdown lead for Illinois Tech, but now it's time to go for 2 as we are in our 3rd overtime period. Barrow carries, and he is in again, and he will just trip his himself into the end zone. So kind of interesting there. But a touchdown for Illinois Tech and a two-point conversion. Eight-point lead. Can their defense make some plays here? Smith running, throws to the right side for Carmona, and they pick up another first down. Cass Jr., the man in motion. They go left side again. Smith is brought down. No gain. Second down and goal upcoming. Probably keeping this one on the ground. Second and goal. Option right side. Smith is in for a touchdown. He goes in untouched, and this is down to a two-point conversion. And right now, this looks like a battle of ground games as both defenses having a hard time stopping the other team's run game. This is Smith running right, and you've got to be kidding me. Another broken tackle. That could have been the game right there, but Gabe Hunter couldn't bring him down the backfield. I mean, you guys got to make plays in the secondary. You guys aren't that bad. First and 10. It is time for overtime number 5. There goes Cologne. Actually, this is overtime number 4. I'm losing track already. First and goal. This is Smith to the outside, pitching for Cass Jr. He's in for a touchdown to play overtime possession. And Illinois Tech down by a touchdown. Can their defense get off the field or maybe get a two-point conversion? Stop! Hunter was there, but just missed. Unbelievable. Navy up by 8 points again. Here comes the Wolfpack offense on the field. Second down and 6. Can they get in the end zone again to keep this game going? Bishop running hard. Jukes out a defender. Nice move there. They're back inside the 10-yard line. First and goal. This is Barrow up the middle. Barrow spinning down towards the 2 or 3 yard line. Second goal upcoming. But now it's third down and goal. One lineman on the field for Navy from the 3 yard line. That's an easy touchdown for Abraham Barrow. And this is down to another 2-point conversion. Anthony Bishop checks back in for the Wolfpack offense. This is going to be a carry to the outside. And there is no one from Navy's defense on the edge. And this game is heading to a fifth overtime period. 61-61. How many points will we put up in this ball game? This is Bishop to the outside, inside the 5-yard line. There goes a touchdown, and there goes the school record for rushing touchdowns in a game. But no one can celebrate quite yet. This game is not over. 67-61. 2-point conversion for the Wolfpack. They will keep this on the ground again, just keeping this ground game going to the outside, staying away from that left side of the field. And Illinois Tech leads by 8 points again. Smith looking to throw, steps up, end zone for Tillman. Oh my goodness, unbelievable. Deion Reeves was there, and then he wasn't there, and then Navy is a 2-point conversion away from tying the ball game up again. What is going on with this defense? Smith keeps it, and he's going to walk in untouched. 69-69, 6 overtime periods. Here we go again. Smith to the air, will look to throw. He's got White with a tough grab in traffic near first down. Nice catch. Second down and inches. They'll go back to the ground game. Smith keeping it running right side. Nearly threw it in the traffic, but it's going to be Romine down to the 1 yard line. First and goal. Smith keeps it. He's going to cut upfield himself. He is in for another touchdown. 75-69. And here goes another 2-point conversion. Illinois Tech can blitz as many guys as they want. They are not getting pressure. As Smith goes to the air, and that's a touchdown for Tyler Carmona. And Illinois Tech trailing by 8 points again. When will the overtime period end? 77-69. Wolfpack looking at second down and 5. Bishop still in the game. And they will run the ball right side again, taking it to the edge. Bishop up the sideline. He's inside the 10-yard line again. He is special. Good blend of speed. Good blend of elusiveness. Just making guys miss. Here goes Barrow up the middle. He will power his way, and that's why he's in the ball game. Touchdown, Abraham Barrow. And we are a 2-point conversion away from this game going to 7 overtimes. Barrow carries right side. This time Navy almost there to make the play, but good blocking on the edge by the fullback Bennett Hayden. And that's going to send this to a 7th overtime. Illinois Tech keeping this one on the ground. There goes Barrow lowering the shoulder, runs through a defender. First down, Wolfpack. Ball inside the 15. Barrow gets it once again. Barrow lowering the shoulder. He is near the first down marker. They're going to give it to him again. First and goal, Illinois Tech. This time going to the option. Kelly trying to get around the edge. He is spun down and brought down at the 5-yard line. That'll lose about 2 or 3 yards. Second down and goal. Barrow still in the game. No sign of Bishop. He's not injured. He's just resting. And it's going to be Barrow in for another touchdown. There goes number 4 for him. And here goes another 2-point conversion for Illinois Tech, trying to send this to maybe an 8th overtime. That is Barrow to the outside. He's going to get around the edge, and he is in for another 2-point conversion. So Bishop didn't run the ball at all, that overtime possession. Here goes Navy on offense, and this defense needs to make some plays. Smith throws to the sideline for Carmona. That is caught, 6-yard gain for Navy. This time, Cass Jr. moving in motion. They go option right. Smith able to fall forward. That's a first down for him. And here goes Navy inside the 10-yard line. Second down and 2. Smith keeps it, runs right side, trying to get in the end zone. He will do just that. It's 83-85. The scoring just does not stop. Navy to the line. 2-point conversion coming up for them again. This is a give inside to White, and Corbin's there to make the stop. This ball game is over. Finally, we end this after 7 overtimes. Illinois Tech wins 85-83, and Anthony Bishop, 33 carries, 233 yards. Illinois Tech moves on to 3-1 on the season. If this is how all the overtime games are going to go for Illinois Tech, I don't want to play another one, but I'm a little confused as to why Smith gave it up the middle to White there. If he had kept that, he's got himself and Cass Jr. on the edge, and they're maybe in for a touchdown, but I'm not complaining because this game was making me late for work. I literally started this game like an hour and a half before I had to leave for work thinking, you know what, I can get in a quick game, and this ended up being like almost a 2-hour recording, and I almost ended up being late for work, but I got there on time because I'm a speedster. But what a game from this offense. Sean Kelly, you know, that one INT, if that could have been avoided, this probably wouldn't have gone overtime, but great game on the ground by both Bishop and Barrow. Probably would have seen a better game from a lot of the receivers through the air if the ball was actually thrown in overtime, but because I was, you know, kind of like, okay, I need to get out of here and go to work, I kind of just kept the ball on the ground and just didn't risk, you know, throwing an INT. But what a game. Both teams over 300 yards on the ground. Navy actually threw for 251, which was kind of crazy. Both teams pretty good in the red zone, but it came down to that one final 2-point conversion. Look at all the scoring in this game. 7 overtime periods. I have never played a game like this, and I never want to play one again. So we will head into our second bye week of the season, week 6, as we have a bunch of guys ready for visits. And it's going to be time for our first recruiting update of the season coming up next week. But Illinois Tech at 3-1 is now second place, or they're still second place in the MAC East, and Toledo still first place in the MAC West. So we have a bye week next week, but in week 7 after our bye week, we take on Miami, Ohio, who have started the year 0-4. Here's an updated look at the Heisman Top 5, and here's a look at your NCAA Player of the Week, Tago Smith, who absolutely destroyed our defense. But Anthony Bishop was MAC Player of the Week on offense, so a great showing from him. And I don't know if this can be avoided any more than it already has, but Anthony Bishop has shown that he is the future of this team, and he will be the starter from here on out for the Illinois Tech Wolfpack. Caden Garrick is now the backup. Anthony Bishop is the starter. So, up next in week 6, this video is already done, so it should be coming out tomorrow. You guys will get the first recruiting update of the season as we're going over the new board. There's been quite a few changes, but we'll go over that in the next video. Thank you all for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. Sorry for the wait on this video. Those of you that follow me on Twitter, this was supposed to be out on Tuesday, but I ended up losing my voice doing videos on Monday. So the first half of this video was kind of like a little raspy, and I finished the second half today, which is Thursday. And you guys will get this video on a Friday because I'm trying to stay on a schedule of Tuesday and Friday for uploads for this series. But thank you all for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. I will see you tomorrow for the week 6 recruiting update. Have a nice day, everyone. See you later.